Did you know that new updates of iTunes, even though they usually add new features, may occasionally stop old ones from working? Hi, I'm Dan Afonso from Enfold IT and Afonso Consulting, and this is how to install and update iTunes on a Windows PC. Now, iTunes is a great little music application, and you need it if you've got an iPod to do the updates and to store your music. iTunes is easily installed, and it's not that difficult to upgrade. In fact, it's the same procedure. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to iTunes.com, which will bring you over to the correct web page. And it's conveniently got a nice download link right there, which we're going to click, bring it up, and it's going to bring this up. Now, it's automatically choosing which one to get for you. If you're going to install on a different machine, make sure you pick the version that is for that machine. For instance, if you're running 32-bit version of Vista or 64-bit version of Vista, just be on the lookout for that. Now, it has a couple questions about sending you information, periodic updates, and new music that's coming out. And that's great, but I don't really want to do that right now. So I'm going to uncheck those, not give my email address, and hit download now. Save box comes. Boom. Download. I'm just going to put it on the desktop, put it anywhere you want. Doesn't really matter. All right. It's just about finished downloading, copied over. There we go. Close this and fire up iTunes setup. You're gonna get a safety warning on Windows XP. Vista's gonna give you the dark screen and give you the request for higher permission. Don't worry about it, it's fine, as long as you trust stuff from Apple. The iTunes installer is pretty basic. You're going to probably wanna take the defaults on everything. The only ones I usually change are these over here. I don't really want icons all over my desktop and everywhere else, but automatic update, I do like that. So I'm going to turn off it, putting the desktop shortcuts and being the default player. Windows Media Player is still a little bit faster to load, so I'm just going to run that. So now it'll do its installation. Be aware, when you install iTunes, it does install a lot of services for iPods. Those can be disabled. There are tutorials out there on the web on how to do that. If you do have an iPod, you'll need to run them in order to get your iPod to sync properly with your machine. Yep, looks like it's done. So, I'm gonna finish up here and it's gonna open up iTunes. That's pretty much it. If you're doing this as an upgrade, it'll be the exact same procedure, only you'd still get this, but you wouldn't have to import all your music or anything. It'd be there already. I'm Dan Afonso, and that's how you install and upgrade iTunes on a PC.